Hi, we're here today in Dumbo to meet with Tina Roth-Eisenberg. She actually is a young blogger and designer, better known as SwissMiss. I'm sure you already know her. Let's go and see her.
Hi, my name is Tina Roth-Eisenberg. I'm a Swiss designer gone New York. Most people know me by my Twitter handle called SwissMiss, and that is also the name of my blog. It's swiss-miss.com. It's a design blog that I started six years ago. And I run several businesses out of Brooklyn Dumbo. One of them is Tattly, a temporary tattoo business, and CreativeMornings, a breakfast lecture series that has gone global. And I started a to-do app called To-Do.
So, hi Tina, can you maybe tell me what led you in New York?
I graduated from graphic design school in Munich and had this dream of living in New York for 3 months. And in 99, after I graduated, I wrangled my parents into supporting the idea of me living in New York for 3 months. And I came here and I had one interview lined up for an internship, and that turned into a job right away. So the 3 months have now turned into 13 years. But I'm not leaving, and I found my new home.
That's cool.
I started my blog because I was Swiss and I was very organized, so every day I would collect things that I find on the web and that would inspire me, and I would put them away to really neat bookmark folders. But I don't remember a name for the life of me, so I would go into my bookmark folders and trying to find these things again, and as I don't remember the names, I would have a really hard time. So I realized I basically need a visual archive for myself. And that's why the next best thing was to start a blog. And this is like way pre-Tumblr days. I mean, if it was now, I probably would have just started a Tumblr. But then it didn't exist yet, so I started a blog, and at the time, which is interesting, bloggers usually wrote really long articles, and I just basically captured images and a link. So I think I surprised people a little bit in the way I changed the format just to suit my own need, which really was a visual archive. And then over time, it's just grown, and what I thought was a personal archive has become more and more public, and over the years I was able to advertise into it. It all happened very organically. I never started this thinking I would make money of it. And now I have a reader base of about 1.2 million a month, which blows my mind, given the fact that I grew up in a town in the Appenzeller Mountains with 3,000 people. So sometimes just for kicks I do the math, and I think, how many times does my hometown Speicher fit into my readership, and it usually cracks me up. I'm a firm believer that where you live impacts, or as a visual person, I'm a firm believer that your surroundings are really important to you. And for me, when I arrived in New York and everyone was like talking fast and had ideas and they're all makers and doers and they want to create new things, I kind of felt like I was home and I was like incredibly inspired, and I felt like all of a sudden I've arrived in a place where people have as many ideas as I have, but they also make them happen, and I think New York is, for a creative person, is like heaven. It's like dream come true. It can also be exhausting because there's a lot of competition, there's a lot of really talented people, but if you are somewhat ambitious and want to be a creative person and really want to make a cool project, work on cool projects, New York is really the place to be.
So a typical day in Swissness land right now is that I come to my studio, the co-working space that you've seen in some of these shots that I started a few years ago, where I rent out desks, and we're a community of 30 people, so that's where I work off. And I usually come in, and for the first 2 hours I maintain my blog, SwissMiss, my design blog, and then I usually switch over to Tattly, which you can see behind me. That's the temporary tattoo business I started sort of as a joke a year ago, and now employs 5 people, which is amazing. Right now we're in the Tattly office, which is just down the hall from my co-working space. And we are obviously growing, and we're sourcing new designs on a daily basis. We're trying to figure out wholesale. So it's a steep learning curve, but it's a really fun experience, and I have an amazing team that helps me with growing Tattly. And then also on top of that, I started a breakfast lecture series 3 years ago called Creative Mornings here in New York, which I never expected to expand globally, but now at this point we have 31 chapters in over 6 continents. And it's a free breakfast lecture series that I'm just trying to get to the level where it's going to be self-sustaining. We're not there yet, but I'm very hopeful and optimistic. And that team is a team of 2, with me it's 3. So I sort of go back and forth between my blog, the temporary tattoo business, and the Creative Mornings breakfast lecture series.
So Tina, let me know, how does your Swissness influence your work here in New York?
Well, I guess when you grow up in Switzerland with the minimal Swiss aesthetic that we all love, it definitely influenced me and my aesthetic as a kid and what I consider good design. And when I moved here, I didn't realize how strong the brand of Swiss design is until, you know, I started interviewing and they said, oh man, you're Swiss, and they would all pull out their graphic design books with like Joseph Miller Brockman and all that, and instantly wanted to like know everything about Swiss design that they might not have learned out of the books yet. And I realized, ooh, that's a huge marketing advantage that I have as a Swiss designer. So I made my tagline early on into Swiss Designer Gone New York. And I'm actually pretty sure that it has opened a lot of doors to me just because I am from Switzerland, which is not necessarily not fair for other people from other countries, which might have been better designers than me. But anyway, so but I also really do love the Swiss aesthetic, and it shows in my design work. You know, I love the white space, I love the grid, I love it minimal. And I think, for me, being in New York, it has been a huge advantage, and the Swiss brand really is strong. Globally, I think, the Swiss design brand. And I hope that the Swiss at home know of their like sort of marketing advantage over other countries and take it to a good cause and take it to a, and represent it well.
Okay, so Tina, thanks a lot for this interview.
You're
it was
welcome.
Amazing meeting you today. And I wish you all the best for the rest of your career.
Likewise.
Thank you.
Now we got to tap you guys up.
Yeah. Thank you.